and the other members of the Fever Squad. We're gonna look.
Dire team done.
Yeah, I'm okay. Let's see what we get for a first ban. Invoker. That's easy to believe after the stomp last game. For those just now tuning in, these folks just played another game and they really went off on the Invoker. Went beyond godlike, was literally double the next hero's net worth. So they don't want to face that again. But that game was all random, so they didn't have the greatest early game lineup either. I think we'll see a much more competitive game this time around.
Reserve time.
Dipping into reserve time for the first ban. I don't know if they're looking for some respect bans. These teams should know each other fairly well. Wouldn't think they need reserve time for any bans just going for the current meta. Well, I hope they don't have an AFK leader. That would be terrible. There we go. We get a Witch Doctor ban.
Dire team ban.
Interesting first ban. I must think they have something in mind that Witch Doctor screws with to ban him that early.
10 seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining. Reserve time.
Slark banned out.
Radiant team ban.
And Anti-Mage banned out. Interesting couple of bans from the Radiant squad.
Storm
I have to assume those are targeted bans. I can't think of any reason for those to be banned first. Quick
pick.
Storm Spirit lock for the Dire. Well, it's an early draft of Storm Spirit. All his counters are still in the pool. But pretty much every one of these people is a better player than me, so I assume they know what they're doing. Radiant giving it some thought.
Remaining. 5 seconds remaining.
Disruptor. Is he going to dip back into the reserve time? No, quick Disruptor.
Radiant
one of many counters
pick.
To the Storm Spirit. I like that pick for a support. Relocate to send Storm back off of a zip, or the ulti to keep Storm from going anywhere. I like that a lot. One of my personal favorite heroes. I miss the old days when people would let me play a mid. Way better mid than you'd think. You know, for pubs. Never in a competitive game. That would be stupid.
10 seconds remaining.
Not sure what they went for the second pick. They definitely went for the Disruptor quick to counter the storm.
I speak for the trees.
Nature's Prophet. Doesn't see a lot of play these days. Although after PPD just completely wrecked with him at DAC, I think we're starting to see him show up a little bit more. Not PPD. Bone 7 was the one that played an excellent Nature's Prophet at DAC. Lycan banned out.
Ban.
Yeah, with the Prophet already picked up, definitely don't want to let the Radiant get on a nasty push lineup here.
Ten seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining.
Omni-Knight banned
ban.
Out. Yeah, it seems to be the universal rule of Dota 2. You either love Omni Knight or you hate him because you hate playing against that ult. And if the Dire is looking to do a lot of right-click work, you definitely don't want Omni in there.
10 seconds remaining. 5
especially
seconds
without a hero like Storm
remaining.
Speed for yourself to jump in and blow him up before he can cast anything.
Reserve time.
Ancient Apparition banned out.
Radiant team ban.
That'll make it a little harder to get an early gank with Nature's Prophet teleport. That Ancient Apparition bonus damage really makes those TP and ganks nasty in the early stages.
Reserve time.
Dipping back into the reserve time here for this fourth ban. I don't know if they're targeting a player in specific or just certain general abilities they don't want to see. The Dire, I would say, are banning a lot of the really good gank heroes, with the exception of the Lycan, just want to keep him out so they don't get too pushy of a lineup, but AA, Slark, and Evoke are all heroes either great at ganking or assisting in a gank. My global Ancient Apparition ult. Razor banned out.
Radiant team pick.
What's funny?
Oh, shoot. I have open mic.
Okay. My co-caster has the giggles, everybody. It's all right. She knows these players better than I do. I thought maybe there was a funny reason for banning Razor. Respect ban or a troll ban. I don't know which.
Oh, not really. I don't know any of these people.
Remaining.
Oh, okay. Well, then you're as in the dark as I am.
Babe. 5 seconds remaining.
Radiant really taking their time, making sure to give a lot of reserve thought to these picks. Time. The downside of that is they have 3 picks to make and only 20 seconds of reserve time, so they better figure this out. They're going to have to make some panic picks, which never ends well, from my experience.
10 seconds remaining.
Well, the Shadow Fiend. That'll almost certainly be our mid. So Shadow Fiend versus Storm Spirit. I actually don't know which hero wins that matchup most of the time. I would assume the Shadow Fiend, but boy, once Storm gets 6, it seems like he could pretty much go on the Shadow Fiend at will. I'm sure there's some statistics to contradict me, but that one really feels like a coin flip.
10 seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining.
Clockwork. I like Clockwork against the Shadow Fiends. The Blade Mail and the Hookshot to kind of keep him pinned down and to punish him for his own damage. And that should force the Shadow Fiend to an early BKB.
Nyx Assassin.
Oh, Nyx Assassin. My favorite hero from a dead meta. Those players you hated that always took Nyx mid and just went like 20-4 and stomped the game and made you want to just punch your desk in fury. That was me. I miss those days. Not ashamed to admit I ever ride the broken hero train. Sadly, that was back before the days of ranked, where you might have a higher MMR.
5 seconds remaining. Reserve time.
Normally my instinct for the Dire here would be to grab a Bounty Hunter, but I don't think that really fits into their lineup. They've got Clock for the offlane, Storm for the mid. There's not really any place for Bounty to get his farm, although having Track for the Assassin and harassing Nature's Prophet's jungle to death, that might still work.
Shadow Shaman.
Shadow Shaman's a bit of disable and some good hard push. I think my only concern right now is that is a really squishy team. The Lion and the Shadow Shaman are heroes that the Nyx can pick up with, along with a Nature's Prophet TP, should have no trouble just popping whenever they want.
10 seconds remaining.
I wonder if both of those heroes need to get going to get a quick blink to
5 seconds
not just be food
remaining.
All game. Let's see the last ban come out from Dire here.
Dire team ban.
Phantom Lancer. I think that's a good call. Boy, I watched Secret play against that new Phantom Lancer earlier today, and they managed to beat it, but boy, it wasn't easy.
Radiant team.
Juggernaut ban for the Dire. He's a little more in control since the recent nerf to his agility gain, but still a fearsome hero in a lineup that wants to push, and even with only Prophet for a push hero and Shadow Fiend for his right click, that is still a team that can push. You'd think both teams need a hard carry here.
10 seconds remaining.
More so the Dire than the Radiant.
5 seconds remaining.
Lots of options still in the
Reserve
pool.
Reserve time.
Spectre.
Dire team.
Love that hero, but boy, does he get countered, or she get countered easily in the early lanes. We'll see how that plays out. The lanes for the Dire. They've got a pretty decent tri-lane with the Lion Shadow Shaman. They'll just have to get the right carry to play aggressive with. That could really give Spectre a hard time.
10 seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining. Reserve time.
Not sure what they're going to go with here. Part of me thinks a Phantom Assassin could be a good fit, but I almost wonder if a Strength Hero, something a little more durable, could be more advantageous. I haven't seen Sven in a competitive game in a long time. Part of me would love to see that, but probably wouldn't work out great. His low mana pool, Nyx Assassin, will pretty much keep him from ever casting anything in the early part of the game. Dire is as unsure of what to do as I am.
Phantom Assassin.
Phantom Assassin. I think that's a good pickup here. They're going to be pretty strong in the game with the Shadows to push, Clockworm, both able to initiate. PA should be able to pretty much safely blink in from whatever angle she wants and just unleash hell. I think this is a pretty good lineup, both ways. Late game, definitely favoring the Radiant, but I think the Dire may be able to keep it from ever getting that late. Alright, as we load in, let's see who's playing. In who here? Looks like Arcadia is going to be on your Shadow Demon. Excuse me, Shadow Fiend. Dragon Twist on the Spectre. Andres on your Nature's Prophet. Fuck Dota 2 Communication Band, the Mute Lord, on Nyx Assassin, and Thundernut on your Disruptor. On the Dire side, Mana Tick Tick is going to take the Storm Spirit. Frozen on your Phantom Assassin, rocking the Arcana. Black Bull takes the Clockwork. Gory on your Lion. And Dr. Bilal on Shadow Shaman. Both teams moving out, likely to contest these early bounty runes. Prophet going to start with a typical Bassy and two Clarity, so it looks like we'll definitely be seeing him go to the jungle. Next, probably going to take your offlane for the Radiant.
30 seconds to battle.
Scouting Treant from Nature's Prophet there. Boy, this could be a nasty engagement at the bottom rune, although top looks just as likely to turn into a fight.
Oh.
gonna have the fight on top. Oh, Nyx, looking dangerous. Oh, I think Nyx is gonna be your first blood. There it is. Goes to the Shadow Shaman.
To the ancestors.
That's gonna let him grab a quick brown boot. It's gonna make it way easier here for him to be effective in ganks. That's a really good start for the Dire. They've gotta be happy with that. I didn't see what went down on bottom. It looked like the Radiant got that bounty rune, though. Quick glance at the mini map, but I did not see the Dire continuing to pressure.
Denied!
Alright, so let's see how these lanes shake out. Got the line moving towards top, so it looks like it'll actually be a defensive tri-lane for the PA against the solo Nyx. Well, Nyx is going to have a hard time getting much out of that lane. That is going to be super dangerous. Clockwork up against the Spectre and the Disruptor on the bottom. That should be enough for Spectre to secure his farm, although I don't see that ending in much in the way of kills. And then mid, we're going to have our Storm Spirit up against the Shadow Fiend as predicted. Let's see, early start, Storm at 3 and 2, Shadow Fiend at 2 and 1. But that's fairly normal with Shadow Fiend's low early damage. He should catch up pretty quickly. PA having an easy time on top. Nyx having the good sense to stay back. Let's see if he's going to move in here. Oh, this could be dangerous, but Shadow Shaman's not walking his way. Did Shadow Shaman go for those quick boots? He did not. He finished up a bracer. I am being told that the folks watching the Twitch stream cannot hear me. Anyone has any theory as to why that might be?
Fine. You good?
And that's on Twitch, you can hear me just fine?
Yeah.
Okay. I hear a player telling me she's got no sound at all. I'm not sure why that would be, but if you guys all hear it just fine on Twitch, I don't know why she wouldn't. She said it was working earlier until the game started. Shadow Fiend gets double raise. Looks like he's just gonna have to back it off though. And Nyx still being fairly aggressive with his position here, harassing that line a little bit. Shadow Shaman rotates down to help him, and Nyx has already walked away. Spectre giving some right click to clock. He's got his bottle up, though. He shouldn't really have much in the way of fights there. Quick boots and poor man shield for Spectre. Not bad. Sound seems to be fine now. And we've got a pause. The bane of broadcasters everywhere. And players, frankly. That's fine. We'll take a look at this pause. Dire really doing well with the last hits. Both PA, Clock, and Storm Spirit. All right at the top. Nature's Prophet's the only one doing terribly well for the Dire. Spectre at 9-0. She's doing okay in the safe lane, but she's actually getting hit less hit and denied by the clockwork. Game resumes now. Nyx walking away from Lion. Let's check the mid lane. Shadow Fiend keeping Storm Spirit low. Bottom lane. Not much action here, just back and forth. One moment here, guys.
That'll take the wind from their sails!
Nyx. An interesting position here, but not anywhere that's getting XP. He is still level 1. Penny Arcade. Chain of Assassin from PA. Wow. Is having a good time. Uh-oh. Nyx walking into a trap here. Oh, this should turn into a kill if Shadow Shaman can get in range. Blink, yeah, this is your Nyx going down. Oh, Creep gets the last hit, so the gold gets distributed evenly. That PA is still snowballing pretty well. She's got her treads up. Most of a poor man shield if she wants to finish it.
Wow, look at that.
Apparently Twitch is causing some problems with the sound going in and out. for some viewers. So I apologize for that. That's kind of beyond my control. Bottom lane. Clocking some trouble. He's invisible, but the Disruptor Thunderball is going to show them where he is. Yeah, he walks out just fine. Clockwork's still doing pretty well here on the bottom. Only hero with more farm from the Radiant side is Nature's Prophet. Looks like he is going for the Midas. He just has the Bassy and the Gloves of Haste and is jungling away. Is he cliff jungling? Oh gosh, he is cliff jungling. Report Peru. My gosh.
Turn your blade.
Nyx does up to level 3 now. Not bad considering he was just level 1 a moment ago. Storm Spirits to hold the zone in the mid. Lion pokes his head out. Shadow Fiend didn't see him. Farming up this jungle camp. Oh, looks like we may have a fight going on the bottom. Clockwork, battery cell's on, and he backs it off. That creep wave wasn't really in their favor for that. He's gonna need the hook shot if he wants to go in behind the creep wave like that. Nyx picks up a haste rune. Bottom battery is gonna go to the storm spirit. And he's gonna keep moving towards the bottom. He's got his 6. I think they're gonna look to gank the Spectre. Slow down the farm. Is he gonna go for the jump? Nope, he just backs it off. Ward saw it coming. A good vision out from the Radiant saves them from a Storm Spirit gank. He TPs back mid. Does not dive behind the creep wave. On top, Nyx eating some dagger harass out of the PA. She continues to free farm, learning out at 38-7, the 7-minute mark. That is excellent. She's got her treads, picked up Ring of Regen, definitely heading towards the Battle Fury. So that would tell me she's looking to farm this and take this game a little bit late rather than try to win super early. Clockwork bottling up here. He's got hookshot up. That Spectre does not have enough mana for a dagger. If he can land a decent hook, he might be able to blow her up quick enough. Probably a bad risk though. Looks like they're gonna call for a gank on the Shadow Fiend. Lion rotating around. Shadow Shaman also walking that way. I'm gonna leave PA to farm against the Nyx. He's getting his levels now, he's up to 4. That early Lion harass didn't pay off like he hoped. Didn't manage to steal much in the way of jungle creeps. Let's check our hero levels here. Our mid-heroes leading at 8, as expected. Boy, the dire supports, though. 4 and 3. All the supports for the Radiant, at least 5. In the next minute or so, that is going to definitely help them out in team fights. Shadow Fiend picks up your top rune. Bottom looks like it's going to go to Lion. Or did go to Lion. Shadow Fiend senses something's up, keeps the illusion out front. And he knows all 3 of those heroes are there for him. And he's not going to risk himself. Smart move. Boy, Radiant just now upgrading their courier 8.5 minutes in. Not sure what held that back.
Over here now.
Shadow Fiend putting a little pressure on Storm. Pretty passive early game. I think Clock would be looking to make something happen with this level 6 hook shot. Oh, apparently he must have whiffed one that I didn't see. He's got it on
cooldown. Dire's middle tower is under attack.
Nyx up to 5, pushing 6. He should have that soon. Got the nice ward in their jungle to keep the lane pushed towards his tower and let him get his XP. Dire throwing some pings out of the Radiant Jungle. Not sure what they're looking for. I see the Disruptor. Gets a ward down and walks out. Clockwork has Disruptor coming behind him. He doesn't have much mana. Oh, he may be in trouble here. Gets out of the static field. Limps back. And it looks like he's going to be able to walk away. Oh, Storm of Spirit. They catch Nature's Prophet in the jungle. They'll pull that kill.
Nature's Prophet is just plain gnarly.
Dire's middle tower is under attack.
I'm going to try to find Spectre over here in the trees. Storm. Doesn't put his Q far enough in to see him. Spectre's able to TP out to safety.
Radiant's top tower is under attack.
Let's see if Dire's going to make a push on the bottom lane. We've got the Clockwork Hook in 10 seconds. Shadow Shaman almost to 6. No wards quite yet. Okay, still free farming by herself on top. Boy, they're going to have to slow her down. She's way out in front.
Dire's middle tower is under attack.
Storm zips in on Disruptor. Hex. He's going to go down. Nick's got his level 6. He's in Viz. Or is he going to go on this? It's 4 on 2. And they'll pick up the Shadow Shaman kill. So 1 for 1. About a third of life taken off the tier 1 tower. That is pretty much an even trade right there. Only about 10 gold advantage going to TV Radiant. Checking our early graphs, fairly even. Slight advantages for the Dire. Most of that's going to be the PA's farm. Ooh, Disruptor TP's in on the PA. She just goes on him. Oh, one more dagger. She gets the hit. A little bit aggressive of a TP for a solo Disruptor up against a farming PA. How's she doing towards that Battle Fury? Perseverance is online, has the treads. And 500 gold in the bank. It looks like the courier is bringing her Claymore. So she's about 700 gold off the Battle Fury.
Radiant's top tower is under attack.
That's going to be a really nice timing for Battle Fury Triss. Spectre giving the Clockwork a chase. He's got Hookshot in 3. And he's got help coming from Storm. Oh, if he can get the hook. No, they're just going to let her walk away. Prophet throws out a farming ultimate. Nyx, Clockwork, stun. No, he's dead. Nice kill for the Radiant there.
Dire's bottom tower is under attack.
I think I might have missed a kill. No, I didn't. But PA did get the last hit on the tower on top, so that should have her Battle Fury where she was. That Battle Fury is 20 gold away. 12 and a half minutes, Battle Fury treads. That is excellent.
Tower is under attack.
She is going to be a force to deal with through this mid-game. Spectre. Farming into the Dire Tier 1. Storm TP's in. Is he going to jump? No, doesn't jump for it. Boy, she didn't have any help there. He must have been afraid of supports in the trees, because that would have been an easy kill. She might have been able to ult out, but... PA, going on the Disruptor, glimpses back. Doesn't quite have what it takes to finish him. Boy, that was close. One more right click and he was gone. Oh, there's Storm goes on. Spectre bottom. Oh, Clockwork's the Storm. Nick's in position to try a counter gank here. But the numbers are not on his side. Nyx. Oh, is it dead Storm? It is. Nice counter gank. Spectre managed to escape the kill, and they pick up the Storm Spirit in exchange. Very, very nice. Radiant pinging out the bottom. Oh, it was Lion pinging out the bottom, excuse me. PA goes back to farming top. The Battle Fury complete. Her farm should start to skyrocket. We'll see what she goes for her next item.
Dire's middle tower is under attack.
Regen rune goes to the Shadow Fiend on top. Clockwork grabs the bounty on the bottom. 4 Dire heroes bottom. I think they're looking to fight. Storm zips forward. Doesn't quite get there. We go. Got the Spectre. She's the boy. She shouldn't get away from this one. But she's gonna anyway. Prophet TP's like, oh, there goes the hook on the Spectre. They get her. I think Locke's going to pay with his life in the back. Nope, manages to walk away from the Disruptor. Nyx. Oh, Lion's going to die here. Storm. He's going to pick up the Nature's Prophet.
Dominating. Double kill. Double kill.
Spear right clicks Disruptor down into the ultimate.
Spree.
And now it's going to be a man fight between Nyx and Storm. And Nyx is going to win it.
Kill.
Wow. Full 5-on-5 fight. Radiant. Lose four heroes in the Dire side team wipes. Nyx picking up a couple of kills. He is near to his Blink Dagger if that's what he's going to choose to do. But part of me cheers for the old school Dagon. We'll see how that goes down. Looks like Shadow Fiend picked off the mid tier one at some point. I missed that. Sorry, viewers. Spectre now with an early set of drums. Clock. Shot 8. Yeah, he needs to back off of this. The creep wave there. He's not going to get enough battery assault damage to be dangerous. I think Dire wants to go right back on this bottom tower. PA teleports in. Lion's here. Shadow Shaman working his way around. Shadow Shaman wards are up. Shadow Fiend goes back to work in the mid. Shaman with the Orchid. Looks like he's going to pick up. Excuse me. Storm Spirit with the Orchid. Going to pick off Nature's Prophet.
When you strip away his leaves, Nature's Prophet.
Let's see how this goes on bottom.
Gnarly.
The dagger grass. Oh, and there goes the hook shot. That is a dead Spectre. Finger on the Nyx just as he ults. I should make him think twice about trying to pick anyone off here. Ward's committed. They should get this tier 1. And PA gets the last hit. Well, her farm is getting out of control. Net worth up to 8,500. 2,500 above the Shadow King. Storm Spirit also doing alright with a nice 500 lead. So, two of Dire's cores well in the lead. Clockwork kind of right in the middle of the pack. That's definitely a nice position to be in. Oh, PA with the dagger crits. Yeah. Nyx's killing streak ended by the Lion. Shadow Fiend farming a dangerous place here. They may know about it. Storm coming around. Oh, Shadow Fiend feels the pressure and blinks, but he's got himself stuck on high ground. But I don't think the Dire sees it. They know he's there somewhere. Shadow Shaman's got an observer. He can spot this out if he tries to ward. Nah, Shadow Demon managed to blink across. Mid. PA going on Disruptor. He drops the ult, but he's going to die for it. And PA walks out. Hex hook. Oh. Shadow Beast. Gone. Oh. Well, I was going to call that a questionable ult from the Spectre, but he got one kill and he may get a second.
Kill.
Two. Prophet goes for PA. She's got 3 points up in Blur. I don't think he can do this. Yeah, Storm's going to pick him off for his trouble. And now they're going to turn on the Spectre. Orchid. Line to stay back, buddy. Oh! Nyx Assassin with a sick double impale. You may as well call it a Ravage. Nyx doing everything he can to keep Radiant in this game, and it looks like he is going for the Dagon. Yeah, buddy. Haste snagged by Disruptor. He looks like he's going to just go use that to push out bottom. Let's check our items here. Spectre working towards either a Yasha or a Diffusal. Blink Dagger up for the Shadow Fiend, working towards BKB. Midas and a Mithril Hammer for our Nature's Prophet. Clockwork working towards the Ags, a little more than halfway there. Gory has nothing yet. Storm has Orchid, Bottle, not sure where he's going with the second Sage's Mask. It looks like PA is almost to the BKB. The Ogre Club and the Mithril Hammer in her inventory. Bring up that fact about Brickleback's name. I didn't see that till the end. What was his name going to be?
Fortune's changed.
Killing spree.
Bristle Bog. I remember that now. Yeah, they weren't sure if they could use the old Razorbacks from World of Warcraft and Warcraft 3 without an IP issue. Thankfully, Bristleback has not been given the Wind Ranger curse yet. Looks like we're going to get some ancient stacking out of the Dire.
Dire's top tower is under attack.
No doubt for PA, unless Shadow Shaman just walks in and blocks it for fun, which he did not do. Nyx grabs him a bounty rune. Looks like a real moment, although Prophet looks like he's going to push the bottom tier 1.
Let's
see if Dire care to respond. They don't have a glyph. TP from Clockwork. Make sure Prophet will back away. Radiant grouping up here near the Rosh Pit. Not sure if they're just looking to secure this rune. Nyx. Ulting up towards the Dire Secret Shop. There's definitely targets he can find here. He's almost got his Dagon 2. He is not going to go hunting through the trees. Probably wise. This is a level 2 ult from Nyx, though. He's got some time to scout this out. That is true. Not the only line in this game dedicated to Terminator 2, either. Some fun trivia for my co-caster here. Radiant still content to just farm. Dire content to let them, given that they have the advantage already. 1k in XP. Only a 2.5k gold lead. Feels like more. But there's a pretty big gap in Dire between the haves and the have-nots. Blocked with the Prophet. Oh no! Traps them both underneath the battery assault. Disruptor throws the ult, but I don't think he's going to survive this either. Spectre comes in. Should pick up the kill on the Clockwork. Does. Penny Arcade getting away from a battle here. She's got her BKB up. Did she use a charge yet? No, she has not. Did I call her Penny Arcade again? Oh my god, because her initials are PA, and I always think of PA as Penny Arcade. Scrub Lord casting here, sorry. Phantom Assassin, PA, not Penny Arcade. Nyx has the level 2 Dacon recipe. Yeah, shameless plugs, that's what it is. Gabe actually paid me to drop the PA name as many times as possible in this cast. Nyx gonna go pick up his Dagon recipe. Courier getting hogged by his teammates. I know that feel. Maelstrom up now on your Nature's Prophet. See Storm Spirit working towards the Bloodstone. Sol Ring is online. Lion. Had a lot of gold built up earlier. I guess he spent that on the Mana Boots. Not looking to get a blink this game. Shadow Shaman. Picked up a Staff of Wizardry. Not sure what he's going to build out of that. Blink on the Spectre. Oh, she BKBs the Glimpse. Is she going to get him? No, Spectre goes high ground and gets away. But she picks up Disruptor. Nyx. Looking for a kill here. I think he could get the PA. Let's see if he goes for it. He's got to stay back out of that Cleveland. Boy, four heroes there.
Nyx, Nyx, Nyx.
He's thinking about it. His ult's got a few more seconds left. He needs some backup here. He can't go in 1v4. He'll pay with his life if he does. Yeah, too much regen on the PA now. Too late. Ult off cooldown in 20 seconds. Oh, Lion sees him. Dust. And Nyx will have to run away. Storm Spirit doesn't seem to know the Shadow Fiend's hiding in there. Gives the camera a chuckle. Oh! Glyphs on the PA! She's trapped under the ult. Spectre. Oh! She didn't get away. The Illusion's chasing her down. The Illusion gives it the right clicks. Dagon goes out on the Shadow Shaman. 3-0 for the Radiant. This is stuff they need to get back in this game. Yeah. Fuck Dota the Mute Lord really putting the team on the back of his nicks here. Now the Spectre up to third in the net worth charts.
Dire's top tower has fallen.
Dire picks up the top tower. Last hit goes to the Nature's Prophet. Well, I tell you,
Illusion!
Storm Spirit and Phantom Assassin are well in the lead on their net worth, but the rest of the team is not carrying the weight. Other than Disruptor stuck in the position 5, all of the Dire heroes, Radiant heroes, are well Dire's above the rest of the Dire. Clockwork is way behind. Zipping on the Nature's Prophet, Storm gets another one. Radiant keeps pushing on top.
We've
got the creep wave and the siege wave. Nope, double TP's coming. Let's see if the Radiant's gonna get away. Yeah, Dire doesn't look to chase. Oh, I take that back. Clockwork's getting on his Wheaties. But he is. Doesn't find anybody with the Rocket Flare. Shadow Fiend teleports home, and Disruptor will follow. Storm has his completed Bloodstone. Shadow Fiend gets his BKB. Looks like Prophet is working towards a Shadow Blade. Not sure if I like that choice. With the Nyx on his team, you know that Dire's going to be looking to pick up a gem soon. I think he might have been better off going for the Necro Grove or working towards a Sheepstick. Oh! Clock with a nice hook, but I don't have any vision to expose the Nyx. Well, they've got to get that gem soon. Lion? Oh, he's dead. Dig on. Six Dragons alive. He's got the dig on up to 3. Clockwork. Cogged in. Glimpsed out. Oh, PA with the blanket kill. And now Disruptor's got the PA trapped. BKB comes out. Disruptor. Oh, poor Disruptor. This PA has just been eating him for lunch all game long. That is Disruptor's 7th death in only 27 minutes. Ouch. Looks like the Radiant still wants to go on top. Dire's gonna keep pushing. Spectre, the dagger. Is she gonna blink? Nope. They see Shadow Fiend hiding out to the right, and they will back off. Clockwork's not done, though. He's got his Aghanims. He can pretty much hookshot at will. Wave, let's inspect her. Hookshot! She's just going to hide in the trees. Following the sage advice of Ice Ice Ice. Spectre may come in. She's working her way up. Shadow Shaman's going to go down, and Shadow Fiend's going to form the wards. Another 0 for 2 for the Radiant. Storm Spirit ratting down on the bottom lane. Doesn't look like he's going to get this tower, though. See here. Uh-oh. Nyx is hunting the clockwork. Boy, there's no reason he shouldn't get him here unless he just loses track. Nyx doesn't dive for it. Boy, he could have. Clock didn't have the mana for cogs to push him back. That could have been an easy kill for Nyx. I think the most dangerous thing would have been a TP reaction from Storm Spirit. Nyx still scouting it out. He's got level 16 now, so he's going to be invisible all the time. Storm farming up the Ancients here. He needs to get a little bit more active. PA's got her Basher. They need to really flex that farm. If the Spectre gets out of control, they're going to be in trouble. She's up to a Diffusal and a Yasha now to go with the drums. She can definitely fight. But imagine she'll look to tank up with her next item, maybe finish up the Manta. And head towards the heart. Prophet's got a Shadow Blade completed. There it is, the Storm Spirit gem. Now this is where things get scary. They're going to have to steal away this gem, or Nyx is probably not going to be able to keep up his streak. He's carrying hard at 13-5. And we have more mouse issues. Yay for pauses. Game immediately resumes. Neither team has really made any kind of hints towards Roshan. PA not with a lifesteal item yet, so it's not something she can just go in and solo. Oh, Shadow Fiend getting caught out. Boy, this is an easy kill. Orchid, EKDs, I think that's a waste of a charge. That was a waste of a charge. So rush in the right place. Now there was no escaping from that. 1v4. I respect the effort, but probably would have been better to just maybe try to get an ult off and die. Prophet, gonna see if he can go rat this bottom tier 2. But Storm is rotating in. Storm has the gem. Boy, Prophet better not show himself.
I'm over here.
Storm knows he's around. He's looking for him. Not gonna go far enough south to find him. PA continuing the farm. Boy, she's only 900 gold away from an abyssal. That is scary. Clockwork still just sitting on the Ags at about 700 gold. Shadow Shaman still just has that empty staff of wizardry. Not sure if he's going to go for the ghouls, go for the four staff, or if he's working towards his Ags. Plenty of gold building up on Storm Spirit here, up to 2600. I would imagine BKB is probably in his future. But he could surprise me and go sheep. Prophet bought up a null tally? Working towards a Dagon of his own, I think. Not sure if I like that. Oh! They tanked the jungle.
Killing spree! Unstoppable!
Yeah, they managed to spot the Nyx out, and he picks off the clockwork, but Nyx dies for his trouble, feeding his streak back over. Storm Spirit picks off the Disruptor on the bottom lane while that was going on. Both teams still have all their tier 2s, but Dire has got to be building a lead here now, and it's still only about a 2,000 gold lead. I really expected that to be higher. In spite of that last death, Nyx has done a great job of keeping his team in it and making space. 14-6 on your Nyx Assassin. Dagon up to level 4. That is the definition of space created. Storm with the gem out hunting. Not gonna find anybody yet. No, he may find the Spectre. What, does he go on it? Orchid, pull. Oh, this is a dead Spectre, surely.
Wicked.
Disruptor's there to help with the right clicks. Oh, Spectre's probably gonna pay for helping.
Monster.
Oh, Storm. It's two.
Over here now.
Shadow Fiend. And he zips out of range. Storm now up to 15-3. Oh, clock's about to get jacked in the mid lane. Nyx gets the kill with the level 4 Dagon, and he is all of 30 gold away from level 5. That is scary. Lion, Shadow Shaman, and Clockwork are all pretty much instant kills now for the Nyx. Shadow Fiend gonna try to wrap around on PA. Alright. Prophet TP into help, it's a 2v2. Wards go down, and a missile comes out. Shadow Fiend goes down, Nyx tries to come in. Dagon's down the Storm. But PA trying to pick up the kill. Daggers her Prophet. She can't see anybody to kill him. She'll just whack the tower and walk away. Oh, gets glimpsed back.
Mega
Nyx is low. Boy, he's still in position to jump in if he can. MPA just instantly blows up Disruptor. Yeah, he really shouldn't be walking anywhere near her at this point in the game. It's unfortunate, but if he doesn't have backup, he needs to just be totally out of her vision. Such as a support's life. Nyx, feeling his Wheaties. Leader of the Lion TP. He does, gets the kill. Now going on the PA. PA with the missile stun, and Nyx beats his streak to PA. Can't get the PA down. Blur doing its work. She'll TP back home. Let's see. In the end, Dire gets the better of that. By about 32, only about 300 gold, but 7,000 XP. Despite doing, what is that, 1,600 less damage? Yikes.
Stupendous!
Let's check our graphs here. Lead's starting to swing heavily for the Dire now. Over 5,000 XP, 4,000 gold. Still, it's this late in the game. That's not a huge lead. Contradicting myself there. Just LD things. Oh, Disruptor again. Assumes the Lord of the role of Feed Lord now with 11 deaths. I know I said I like the Disruptor pick for countering Storm, but boy, he just hasn't done enough of it. Scythe of Vice now up for your Storm Spirit. He can pretty much go on anybody. Looks like this game may come down to who can make more space for the team, Storm or Nyx. PA now, flexing her muscles in the rest pit. With a jump from Storm, onto the Shadow Fiend. Oh. Scythe into Orchid. Just no chance to get away. This storm is huge. And the scary thing is PA is even bigger. Abyssal, BKB, Battle Fury, Helm of the Dominator, Treads. She is going to be tough to fight. I think Dire are going to look to push pretty hard with this Aegis. They've got everything they need to end this game now if they want. Nyx trying to scout out a fight. Where's our Storm Spirit with the gem? He is farming top. At this point, I think Storm probably should just stay with the team. Nope. Wind hit. Nope. Glimpsed out. PA gets a dagger on Spectre. Can't blink on it. Oh, Nyx tries to blow up the clockwork, but line here. Quick hex. PA crits him down. Stormy. Disruptor ult goes out. Well, he can't really teleport to any of these, but he does. Finds an illusion off to the right he can use to escape. Does get the pick on Clockwork. Clockwork and Disruptor now competing for the Mail Delivery. Disruptor. Poor guy, he's in the wrong part of town. Dire is barely down mid now. Prophet ult does some work though. That may back them off for the time being. PA, wings on Spectre. Oh, she's got the movement speed advantage. Whiff on the raise, and she'll just walk away. Boy, if Dire had a mech or an urn to keep these pushes going, I think they could end this game. Oh, Storm catches Nature's Prophet again. Not a good game to try to be a rat. 2 and 11 now on your Nature's Prophet. In spite of that, he is the net worth leader for the Radiant. Just spending too much time dead. Split push just isn't what it once was. Just ask Bulldog. Storm, invisible. Looking for kill in mid. He's gonna see the Spectre. No, they're gonna just barely miss each other.
Death and gold are linked.
Oh, he sees her now. Disruptor's in the back. Oh, he's gonna stalk her down now. This is gonna be a kill. Starts with the auto attack. X. Full. Orchid. Prophet TP didn't help. Oh, and he feeds the gem. It goes one for one, and he feeds the gem to the Nyx. Let's see, when can they buy a new gem? Well, it's in stock now, so they can replace it. That's the good news. PA just man-moding down the bottom tier 2. Satanic on him. Jeez. One item from 6 slot, and 1,000 gold in the bank. Shadow Fiend looking to wrap around. Not much mana and doesn't even have full souls. He wisely backs off of that idea.
Radiant's bottom tower is under attack.
14-2 on the PA. She's just having a great game. Almost 300 last hits. 24,000 hit mark. Blinks in. Abyssal on the Shadow Fiend. He's gone in two hits. Profit. Dagger. Blink. Down.
Double kill.
Nyx picks off the lion, but he's probably going to pay with his own life. Dagger, blink, cut, cut, bash, cut, last hit. This is probably going to cost Radiant their bottom tier racks. Definitely the tier 3 and probably their axe. There are buybacks. Shadow Fiend and Nyx could buy back. Where Shadow Fiend doesn't even have half his souls. And the GG gets called. Good game to the Dire. That mid-game power really came out.
Holy shit!
Nyx did his best to keep his team in it, but Storm gave just as much space as he made. TA used it to full effect. Oh, another kill by the Storm. Who has the gem back? Or bought a new one. I don't know which. Just too much free farm there. Level 25, 27,500 net worth on the PA. I think it's 28,000. He hit over 20,000 there at the end. 15,000 XP. Really close game, though, for a long time. Really good on boys. Thanks for listening to the cast today. Really appreciate it. My name is Henrik, along with my co-caster, Mo, spitting out the trivia at you. Have fun and see you next time.